commonly referred to as the Velvet Voice and the Pavarotti of pop, Luther Vandross was definitely the best voice of a generation, and we salute this iconic 10-time NAACP Image Award winner.
Back when I was a child, before life
Singer, songwriter, and record producer Luther Ronzoni Vandross Jr. was born on April 20th, 1951 in New York City.
I sang from the time I was maybe 3 or 4 years old. My mother had a club called Pacino. There's this board game called Pacino. And my mother used to make me sing at each one of those. You know, she used to bring me with her to other people's houses. And, you know, listen to my baby sing, you know. And I used to sing and play a little bit of piano as well when I was young like that, like 3 or 4.
Luther inherited his ability to sing from his father, and by the age of 13, he knew he wanted to sing professionally.
I was 13 years old. There was a DJ named Murray the K who worked out of New York. And each Christmas and Easter, he gave shows at a place called the Brooklyn Fox Theater. And on to the stage walked this girl. She had on a red chiffon dress with spaghetti straps. Never forget that. And she started singing. And I'm telling you, just like those movies, those black and white movies where the spotlight in a nightclub goes on one person on this side of the room and one person on the other side, and they're the only two people in the world that exist at that point, that's how I felt. And it just pierced me like a hot arrow or whatever. And I said, I have to do this. I know I can sing a little bit, but now I wanna be able to do to other people what she did to me that day. And that was Dionne Warwick.
Although Luther had a phenomenal voice, when he performed at the Apollo, the results will surprise you.
I entered the amateur night at the Apollo 4 times and lost all 4 times. You know, now the rumor was that I had gotten booed. You know how things get distorted as it goes from one ear to the next. No, I never got booed, never. But I didn't win.
In the 1970s, Vandross wrote and sang commercial jingles for various companies.
Every day you woke up with the question in front of you, ooh, what's gonna happen today? Because it was all about the phone ringing. You know, every day was just about the phone ringing and who would call. So it would be the producers from Juicy Fruit Gum, would be the producers from the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marine spot, you know? And it was just so exciting, you know, just so exciting.
Vandross also worked as a background vocalist for several iconic artists in the 70s until 1980, when he got his first start as a recording artist.
My first album was called Luther. That was an album I was singing background vocals on tour for Bette Midler and in the studio for Bette Midler. And she introduced me to Arif Martin, who's a world-renowned producer for Bette at that time. And Arif took a liking to my singing and started using me on all the stuff that he produced. Ringo Starr and the Average White Band and Carly Simon and, you know, just everybody. And introduced me to some of the executives at Atlantic Records, who then signed my group Luther. And that's how we got started.
Having experienced his share of false starts, disappointments, and doubts, the Manhattan native never predicted that his aspirations of becoming the decade's most influential enduring male soul vocalist would be realized. Fast forward to the 1990 NAACP Image Awards, with hits like She Won't Talk to Me, Any Love, along with the hit song Here and Now, garnered the romantic soul maestro his first NAACP award for Outstanding Male Artist. Vandross doubled back to win the award again in 1991 while dropping his hit album, Power of Love, the same year, and winning the 1992 NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Album for the LP. In 1994, Vandross circled back to win the award yet again after the success of his 1993 platinum album, Never Let Me Go. Over time, he proved himself to be the quiet storm that simply could not stop raining. Vandross won for Outstanding Male Artist at the awards three more times in 1995, 1998, and 2001, respectively. In May of 2003, the album Dance With My Father was released. The lyrics recall childhood memories with Vandross's father, who used to dance with him and his mother. Despite the lack of promotion due in part to Vandross's hospitalization, Dance With My Father became one of the most requested songs, winning the 2004 NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Male Artist, Outstanding Music Video, and Outstanding Song. With his untimely passing in 2005, Dance With My Father was the last top 40 hit for Luther Vandross. And four decades later, his music's love and endearing warmth never stops. One constant has remained to define his life and musical success: Luther's voice. And with that, we salute the musical icon that is Luther Vandross.